announcing the first of these semi-finals. And I've already made mention of the fact that Canada are the world champions. They're also the Commonwealth champions. And what a quartet they've got, particularly their third and fourth runners. This young fella, Carlton Chambers, the least known of the Canadian quartet. Now, Sierra Leone, Pierre Lisk, and to Uganda, then to Thomas, then to Toure, who's based in Great Britain, and Sanusi Toure. The first four go through to the final. It's the tight inside lane draw for the team from Sierra Leone. The Spaniards, Feo, is their start-off runner, then Jose, he's the Spanish record holder. Mayoral and Navarro to bring them home. Then the Canadians, we've seen Carlton Chambers before. He hands to Gilbert, then Surin, then Bailey, the world champion. We've got the Commonwealth gold and silver medalists in the last two legs. The German, Mike Huke, he sets the German quartet off. Then to Mark Bloom, European indoor 60-meter champion this year. Then Holger Bloom, the twin of Mark, who's also quite useful. And then Florence Swartoff, the hurdler, who was the bronze medalist in the high hurdles. So the Germans looking good, the Ukrainians. They won the European Cup this year. Rurak to Osovic, Kramarenko, and Dologodin. Dologodin, second in the European Cup, 200 meters behind Limpa Christi. The Brazilian's quite strong as well. Silva, then Da Silva. South American champion on numerous occasions, Robson Da Silva. He takes the second leg to Ribeiro and Andre Silva. Ghana, Aziz, Kanza, Agmang, and then Tufour, Emmanuel Tufour. He featured in the 100 and 200 meter championship here. And then in the Ivory Coast, on the outside, Wyota, Frank Wyota, Jens Verduhu, then to Ndri and Matey. So they're not bad either. And really, this is an opportunity for the Canadians to get it right, because they certainly didn't in the first round. They struggled a little bit and almost had the problems. Surin on three, and there's the world champion, Donovan Bailey. What a 100 meter final it was. And he came through it. Now, first four. Well, the Spaniard actually wasn't ready, and the starter has asked the athletes to get up. And the crowd responding to the pole vault in the far end of the stadium. And once they've settled down, then the starter will allow these competitors to compose themselves again and then call them to their blocks. Sierra Leone, Spain, Canada, Germany, the Ukraine, Brazil, Ghana, and the Ivory Coast, the first semi-final of the men's 4x100 meters relay. Brazilian silver has gone off very well, and the Canadians Chambers going well. Oh, and the Germans in terrible trouble. The Germans really having to stretch there. The Ukrainians going well, and so are the Ghanaians on the outside. The Canadians now making some headway from the third lane. And that was a good change by the Canadians. It really was. The Germans have finally left. They had a terrible first change, and they finally left. They're out. The Canadians leading. The Spaniards doing well on the inside, and the Brazilians coming through, and the Ukrainians. And here comes the world champion. Canada 1, Brazil 2, Ukraine 3, Ghana 4. They're the four qualifiers, 38.36 the time. Very, very confident piece of changing by the Canadian quartet this time. They made their mistakes this morning, survived, and then came through very comfortably. And it was the Germans who had terrible change between one and two. That was Huke and Bloom. And then the two Bloom brothers, Mark and Holger, got it all wrong. And they just didn't finish. And as we see this finish here with the four qualifiers, Florian Schwartzoff is walking down the home straight. He didn't have anything to do, actually. The bronze medalist in the high hurdles didn't have anything to do at all. And he stands up, and you can see. The Canadians, a little bit of a visual there from Bailey, so it wasn't totally good. The Ukrainians, in the form of Dologodin, looking good. And Andrei Silva, the Brazilian fourth runner, coming through. And for Ghana, it was Emmanuel Tufour taking the fourth qualification place. Well, it was a good piece of qualifying by the Canadians. And I said the Brazilians looked good. They had a good side. And really, at this stage, they were putting pressure on the world champion. But the world champion showed in the 100 meters what a good finisher he is. And he just coasted through, eased through, looked right, knew he was qualified, and that was it. Well, let's just follow the Canadians now. Carlton Chambers, look at him running to the inside of the lane. That's very, very good technique indeed. And looking for the outgoing runner, they'll have a mark, and let's see how good it was. It looked okay. There's the shout. It was good. It was safe. And the Germans had a terrible problem. But down the back straight, Glenroy Gilbert holding the center of that baton. There's not a lot of baton to give over. He's shuffling it down now, and that was a very good change indeed between Gilbert and Bruni Surin. And a German there, just you caught a glimpse of the drop baton. Surin, though, on the inside, semi-finalist of the 100 meters here. Hands over. Now, Bailey looked round. Now, that's not good, but he was over-cautious. He won't do that in the final, I wouldn't think. But Bailey, very hard over the first part of the race, and then he eases down and looks right. You watch this in a moment. There, it's comfortable, has a little look. The Brazilian's there. He knows he's qualified. And his job is done. Well, the Germans, that's the brothers, the Bloom brothers. Still likeness, the twins. And poor old Florian Schwartzoff didn't get a chance.